We are back in business, and Matt is frustrated. He's trying to make some tracks of his own, but it's not. There's definitely not Fever, which is going to be coming up next, and indeed it is rather ill. It's scary what's coming up next. We are down to just two. That's right. No, not necessarily the grand finals. There are still two players waiting in the wings for their grand final. I'm your host, Alex Machine Richardson, and things are about to get dicey. It's a head-to-head. The winner will go home, be added to the pile of players eliminated, and the winner will join them in the grand final for a chance at getting the lion's share of $20,000. It's big, and who better to go ahead and join us on the couch than none other than the brain behind the whole brigade. Great to have you here. I'll let you introduce yourself.
Thanks. Good to be here. I'm the CEO and founder of Turborilla, who makes the Mad Skills series games.
Awesome. Right, I assume Turborilla came from Tobias. Little throw in there.
No, it's this, you know, you have to find a .com domain name.
Yeah, went hunting.
Yeah, and I really wanted Hypermonkey, but it wasn't available. But then it suggested Turbo Gorilla instead, so I just shortened that.
That's where it came from.
Yeah.
Awesome. I mean, so how has it been for you to witness what has been a first for you guys? I mean, to see this competitive tournament, to see the players, meet them for yourself, you know, the names you see at the top of your jams every week?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Been a new experience for you?
Yeah, it's awesome. Like, these guys have just been names before.
Yeah.
And these guys have proven to us and to everyone else that this is a game about skill.
Mm-hmm. Mad like, skills, some would
mad
say.
Mad skills. Like, you see these guys do amazing things.
Yeah.
But you also see that there's half a second to shave off still.
Yeah.
Like, there's so much skill in this.
It's so much skill. And I mean, what's so fun is that, you know, you've been there since the start, right?
Yeah.
And some of these names have as well. But it's also seeing the old versus the new. The you know, I mean, DJ Ozzy, we see him at that table now. A new name to the pile.
Yeah. And
then you've got someone like Master 52. I'm sure you're no stranger to him. He was actually a big name in your first series, right?
Yeah. He's the guy who taught us that it's even possible to scrub in this game. That's not something I programmed in.
Really?
Yeah,
it's always the case, isn't it, right, Matt? Like, with every game, they find a mechanic that
bunny
was
hopping.
Not planned. Bunny hopping, yeah. Wall running in Call of Duty. It all exists, and it was never intended.
Yeah. So Joe is talking about how he makes the tracks. He designs the tracks for a certain line and all that. And the players surprise him.
Every time.
Yeah. And the players surprise me about my game. Like,
that's so fun.
Yeah.
And, of course, one of the surprises is joining us on the couch. 6'7" did just lose out, unfortunately, but we'll have the great pleasure of having you on the couch for this one. You've just run through Fever. You've just given this next track a go. Now, Joe's theory, of course, one of the lead designers behind this track, he said it's harder than the previous one. Would you agree? I mean, those walls were really upsetting, ZSE in particular, but the whole upper bracket.
Yeah, that last one was tough, but it is getting a lot tougher.
It's getting tougher.
Yeah. I'm excited to see
DJ
how this
Ozzy
goes.
DJ Ozzy and ZSC going to be sweating then. ZSC and them head to head.
I would say if you really want to intimidate themselves, all they got to do is look at the preview for about 5 seconds, and they'll just be like, oh, God.
Well,
it's up there.
Joe Mama So Fast, of course, Joe, that we've been had on the couch, has posted a time of 1 minute 44.
Oh. And I actually think this wasn't even him that did it. I think it was the other level maker that helped create the whole track. I think it was Ryan
that
did this
to
one
post
as well.
The time.
And Joe apparently emailed him and said, you can confirm if I'm wrong or not, but Joe apparently emailed him and said, I can't even do this. You're going to have to send me a replay.
Yeah.
So I heard him saying that in between. This track looks ridiculous.
This is the preview. This is how it rolls. The
You've seen a little bit of this, chat, Cody. Chat, I was going to chat. But what are your thoughts?
What the fudge?
There's just so much you can do there.
Yeah.
They get 60 minutes for this. Just to clarify, no change in time. 60 minutes.
But it's a 1v1, and they're sitting at the same table. If I'm them, I'm messing with each other as much as I can.
It's
I'm sure they'll
head.
Have mutual respect. They'll be good sports about it, but that's where you can start to pick on the... I see you're struggling over there. Oh, you look like you're sweating. You can start to really get on them a bit.
Oh, absolutely. And two of our youngest attendees as well. We have 19 from Austin and 17 coming in from Zach.
I mean, just watching this replay, you can see how many mistakes are being made.
Oh, my God.
it's incredible to think of how many options. Yeah, let's do that again.
We get to see that again. Here we go.
Almost come into a stop.
That's what it looks like when I play the beginner novice tracks, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Man, oh, man. It's
a long one. That's lap
and
one.
And guess what? Yeah, exactly.
Do it again.
Not only is it the hardest track you've seen, you do it twice. So, and I think, Cody, I think you'd have a better idea. I think the second lap through is going to have a slightly different line because of speed variation at the start.
It will, yeah. It'll mix things up, that's for sure.
But, I mean, like, you know how we've said, ZSC, one of the masters of getting that smooth run. We've seen very smooth starts coming in from DJ Ozzy. Is it, do you think, in a 60-minute window, we're actually going to see someone not go casing, not make these mistakes in a 60-minute window? Or is there going to be... There's going to be an error at some point, right, Cody?
Yeah, for sure. Like, to nail this trick in an hour would be pretty impressive.
There you go. It's got everything. Like, if they went shopping for all the different kind of problems you can cause a player, they've kind of got them all there, right?
this is like, I'm glad this is for pros only, this map, because if you put this in the regular game, Tobias, you wouldn't have any player base left. Everyone would just be like, I'm going back to Candy Crush.
Can you imagine you looking at the numbers and going, right, so we've just seen a 50% increase in uninstalls? What have you done?
Joe?
Yeah. And all the level makers are fired. Yeah. We're going back to flat wheelie tracks.
Well, I mean, before we get into this head-to-head, we have to look at a couple of storylines coming into this, because Matt, this is interesting for us. The Master 52 storyline, getting to that final, to that three-man upper bracket, Master 52 was very much, I mean, can I use the word underwhelming? Joe was expecting big things. You're nodding, Tobias.
I was expecting big things, and it was a bit underwhelming. Yeah. Also, but also, I told the guys in there, in the other room, that when the tracks get hard, that's when Master steps up.
He did indeed. I mean, he is in the grand final. We're going to be taking a look at him a little later on at the grand final. In fact, word on the street was he was so nervous for that game, that three-man survival game, he didn't eat. He was so nervous he couldn't handle eating any food. Now he's just stuffing a sandwich in his face as he prepares for that grand final. But it is time to get this lower bracket game underway. You got the phones in hands. You feeling ready? DJ Ozzy and ZSC. ZSC, I want to see a smile on that face. Bring it back. Bring it back.
Where's after I get a decent time in. See my smile
back. Before you open that preview.
We've only seen ZSC on that table once, and that was at the start of the day.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
I hate to be a crusher of spirits, but he says before he gets a decent timing, we may not see him smile until like the last 10 minutes, either of them.
Yeah.
So it's rough. It's a rough go.
Yeah. To get to the grand final, you are guaranteed a prize pool of $2,000.
What is it right now for fourth?
$1,600 for fourth.
Don't worry about that. You shouldn't be aiming for fourth. Aim for third.
It's a $400 bump, and should you get to the grand finals and take first, that's a cheeky seven, 3.5 for second as well.
I mean, this isn't just a battle of survival. They go back into the main game and could still win.
Basically, this is a chance to get $7,000 under your belt in a 60-minute window. It's going to be awesome. So we have got the tradition of letting the most recently knocked out player who joins us on the couch to count us down. Are you feeling ready?
All right, yeah, I'm ready.
Are these guys ready?
I'm excited to see this.
ZSC, DJ Ozzy, at your stations. Are you ready?
All right, 3, 2, 1, go.
Canada versus USA. Austin versus
Oddly
Zachary.
Enough, it's going to be tomorrow's World Junior Championship final. Look at this preview. They both did it instantly, and they both said, what is this?
That's two laps.
This would be a lot easier being one lap. Why are you guys torturing?
Why are we torturing you?
So you can see already at the start, there's an option. I think there's only one fast. The first lap by, second lap you're going to crank that, so you got to remember there's a big difference. But
so it changes the line entirely then?
Yeah. This is like... I don't think we're going to see them get much beyond the 50-meter mark.
There we go, Santa.
Not quite. The right idea.
The damn Santa hit.
It's that down... I don't know. It saved his life at one point, we think.
Yeah, really?
This is crazy.
Who's going to be the first to post the time, do you reckon?
I mean, whoever feels like just throwing in the towel and just running out the track.
To be honest, I could go the whole hour of just
not posting a time. Yeah.
I want to bring you to it.
Yeah.
This is absurd. If this was a ski track, this is like double diamond, triple, quadruple black. Like,
I've heard a rumor that there actually is a line in here somewhere.
There is a line.
You don't say. I can't see it.
Be fun. So if there's a rumor there's a line, the creator couldn't find it. That's what I'm saying.
So you do mostly the physics stuff, which in this game is a massive part of it. You already said that Master found that scrubbing was possible. Is there anything else that players have kind of surprised you with that have gone to a next level?
almost all of the techniques that they use. I didn't think it would be possible to even keep a 1 second wheelie.
Yeah.
And they're doing...
For the whole straight.
They're doing 5-6 second wheelies.
Yeah.
It just depends on how long the straight is.
Yeah.
I guess 6 foot here, he could keep a wheelie forever.
That seems to be a specialty of yours, is just maintaining those wheelies.
Tapping the brake, tapping the gas.
Yeah. We got a wheel broken, and maybe a body as well. I think he's going to ride this out just to make sure he crosses the line. I'm not even touching the refresh button on our time screen because I don't think we need to yet.
Yeah, I think you're right. But once they get some degree of a grip with this, a grasp with this, Matt, we should apply some extra pressure and get that.
No, we totally will. But let's get them. I got to know what they're doing before I can even talk about it in that capacity. So I'm curious to see as well breaking points.
The fact that you land on...
Do you think there's a few spots?
What?
There's a lot of spots, especially the section.
To slow it up.
Yeah, I just finished
the track. That's a nice line.
This is not looking too bad.
This track is insane.
Yeah, Zach's already thinking it's insane. He did put a poster lap in. We'll see what he at least got on that.
So with falling off of his bike, he's only 3 seconds behind the actual map creator.
Yeah. And now the good news is with this too, he's got a ghost to reference. Obviously that ghost doesn't have much figured out, but he can compare a few things off the start if he wants to.
This is truly
absurd. Yeah, the more and more you optimize the ghost, the better you can ride after that.
That's true, right?
Yeah, hitting that one's pretty significant, to land in that. I guess you call that a triple. I think it might even be a quad with all those little lumps that are down there.
Whoa. Some big jumps in there.
That's another start. We talked about this earlier today where you can't just pin it. You've got to be super trigger disciplined off the start.
This looks nice. But you're just going to case it. But you have to, you're going to.
See that?
Do you reckon this could be something that's perfected over like a week? It just could we get a perfect run on it with a week in the jam sesh? With the 12 bodies we have here in Stockholm? I mean, I don't even know.
1 week maybe, yeah, but
certainly not 60 minutes.
60 minutes, no.
Is this a master track? This actually isn't bad. So he went shorter on the first throw, and it gave him a rhythm up to this point, which he's now slowly losing. But also slowly figuring out, which is the more important aspect.
This track is just pure torture.
Yeah. I think it would be interesting, but I don't think we can release this as a jam
no,
track.
No. I think that'd be a mistake.
Maybe just for the pros,
maybe like a pro pool, yeah.
Oh, what is that? All right, physics. Physics engineer, tell me what just happened.
That's the physics engine exploding. Just can't handle that insane track.
Still, once you've been through that, you got to do it again.
He's still got 100 meters on his ghost. 130. After all of that, he's got 130 meters on his ghost. What is life?
Yeah, that is torture to do this twice, and it's.
I wouldn't be surprised if the best time had a crash in it.
that's rare. True. Yeah.
Yeah.
Could be a possibility.
Not being trigger happy on the resets because we're going to be really important then.
I think. I mean, it is two laps. Yeah, there is going to be some rhythms that are repeated.
Oh, there definitely is some.
But starting out that second lap is another ball game. Like, you've got to get that far just to learn that part.
Yeah.
I wish we had a microphone or a camera in the green room right now hearing what the other players are saying. Yeah. That would be very interesting
to
me.
That's true. I think I can hear some bickering from here.
It's almost like you need a checkpoint so you can just go back and practice it.
I forget. There's a game that I used to play that was similar to this. I think it was the Impossible game. It was like one of those puzzle games where you're constantly going through, and they had that. They had a checkpoint system because it was just so hard sometimes.
We have the first replay ready.
Do we?
Yep. You can get that head-to-head, I believe.
Ooh.
Let's have a little look.
So both of them have beat, not surprisingly, because we did see how slow it was, have beat the demo time down into the mid-130s already.
Whoa, yeah, it just looks so chaotic.
5 minutes. Oh,
there it
10.
Is. Yeah. There it is.
Bang. So interestingly enough, we're in eyes with DJ Aussies. Yes, he did accelerate well past the green bike. So it's going to be a question of where that catch-up comes from. I wouldn't be surprised if it was when he did the cartwheel.
I mean, this just shows how much there's still available on the track.
Yeah.
I'm thinking mid-20s if they get this right. If they get this right.
Bragstad has been really quick in figuring out lines. So I would like to see him on this track.
Yeah. I mean, he could be playing it in the other room right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Technically, the finalists could mess with
this. I love it.
That is the best thing we've seen all day. That's how he got him.
He just goes driving by.
That's my fault right there.
The bike just flying around in a vortex.
That's the first time we've seen the physics get confused.
Yeah.
Like, what has just happened to my bike?
Unreal. And that's where, the overtake. Where he finally gets him.
Nope.
On the whoops, though.
Pogo stick.
7 minutes down.
That was a quick 7 minutes.
About 7 minutes to take off each of their times at this point, too.
I mean, when you think about it, is it almost a 2 minute? I mean, what is it? 1 minute 30 track, 1 minute 35. That last 10 minutes is going to be bone crunching.
And in the last map track, Alex.
Yeah.
Stop saying map. The interesting thing is that Austin, we saw him working on that first wall for so long. But then as soon as he hit it, he was able to remember the rest of the track really quickly. That, I think memorization in this one's a massive skill.
Yeah, I also spotted that first wall thing really quickly.
But when the track is so long, memorizing it 6x7 must be an absolute ball ache. I mean, how do you do that?
I would preview the shit.
Preview it, just preview it and preview it, yeah.
You think there's three different lines at least.
Especially when you come into a different section at the on the second lap.
Oh, I got something going on right there.
Bang, that case. Still, and I think both of them are still casing into that drop.
We haven't seen anyone not do that yet, DJLZ, don't worry. Austin, good luck, man.
There's a red button as well as a green one. I can't comment, though. I don't know the intended line. I don't even think Joe does. I don't think anyone does.
No.
This is a Hail Mary.
Is there even a line?
Here's the replay of this. Watch. Where's the bike?
It's coming in next. It's coming from the heavens. It's just flying down.
Stop showing that. It's embarrassing.
The one time we get you with the guys, I think it's great. One thing I will say is added element. I think the background graphics are quite pleasing to look at. I think they're like just cartoony enough, but the ragdoll.
The
ragdoll
is
awesome.
The one.
Eventually, when I'm dying, but when I'm crashing a lot, and I'm frustrated, I'll just let the ragdoll go. I'll just start sending him as far
slide
as I can.
Superman. Like,
all right. Take it out on him,
yeah. Yeah, exactly. I don't have any pain. I don't feel his pain.
Have you ever seen a track like this before, Austin?
Uh-uh.
Uh-uh.
Is there a line that you're supposed to take?
Well, there's definitely a line.
There's a line.
When Joe made the track.
Well, I mean,
It wasn't Joe.
I think it was Ryan. Is that right? I've got a list here. I'll tell you. I want to give credit to the devil that is the creator.
And the line is only rumored.
The line is rumored. So
like,
I mean,
when
you
he
could
made the track, did he think there was a line? Like, did he make one?
I don't think either of you. I don't think anyone
it's gonna
in
find
60
it.
Minutes is going to find a line.
Oh, no.
I think there'll be a compromise somewhere where you're going to be bogged down.
There we go.
Nolan was the one who made the track. There we go. Joe just came in to tell me before
Ryan.
I could get onto that.
He makes some difficult tricks.
Whoo!
Hey, style points.
Sending her. And
that's
there
a
you
line.
Go.
What?
And that could be it's totally by accident. Did you see that as a line?
Yep.
You did.
If you can clear that out, right
that
out.
You can clear that, yeah.
If
you should be able to clear that.
So, and then drop into there. He's going to, I think he's
skips
quite,
it though.
Yeah, I think this is almost process of elimination and a bit of trial and error. But if he keeps doing stuff like this, he's going to find something.
Little hops. And
oh, look, a ghost.
Hey, ghosty.
That's
yeah.
a good one.
So yeah. much airtime.
So that tells us no matter where your line is coming into that lane, you got to be there.
Oh, dearie me. This is going to be, I wish we had like a little crash counter because it would be higher than we've ever seen before.
Oh, remember that 25% reset on cash games?
25% reset, yeah.
The thing with a track like this is like you can get lucky on the first lap and then get it dialed.
Yeah.
It's so easy to screw up on the second lap.
Also got something going there.
Yeah, this isn't too bad. Didn't quite make that gap this time around, but he was able to make up for it by hitting a correct landing.
That's
I think he cased here
smooth.
Last time, yeah.
It's a bit smoother, though. Not quite so violent. He's maintained some momentum, but coming
and
into these.
Again, didn't make it onto that ramp. He's still going to get through these, but remember last time he was able to go pretty much tabletop to tabletop by coming up that main ramp.
Oh, nearly.
Showboating.
Why not?
Oh.
That actually works.
That's a good one.
Reverse scrub.
Yeah, that backflip scrub.
And then what?
That's
a
case.
And then a wall.
It's a briefcase.
Just lays down, very casually.
I'm not going to be surprised if there's a crash in the final.
Yeah, I think, honestly, I don't.
What
I don't
are we at? We're 12 minutes in, and we're still far from finding a good run. We do have a 133 right now on the board for Zach, but that's.
It's not going to stand.
Yeah, it's not fast.
It's not good at all, though. But
Zach's not happy with his 133.
Yeah,
but bearing in mind, my hat theory still stands. Actually, no, never mind. Damn you, 6 foot. My hat theory was that everyone wearing a hat was going to win.
I took mine off.
That's the problem.
Yeah.
We've outlined the problem.
Yeah.
Warm ears wins mad skills. That's what I'm saying.
I also think that that Canadian flag on the sign is the smallest maple leaf I've ever seen in any representation of Canada ever. I just want to point that out.
Are you mad about maple syrup?
Why would I be mad about maple syrup?
Is there something to be excited about there?
Like, oh, like mad, like fiending?
Yeah, you love it.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Oh, look at that.
That's actually...
Not far
Zach
off.
Zach is definitely onto something.
Something, but...
There's the only difference that needs
to be.
But
then how do you ride them out? You just always lose all your speed.
Gotta jump shorter or longer?
Right.
I think you go shorter on entry.
Yeah, shorter, I think so too.
Oh, that rocking.
Yeah, you just hope for the best.
And then that could
but
be easily.
But you're so high, you can't even plan your landing unless you've got...
I think he times that one better. You could probably gap to there. Go all the way over the top section.
That's a start to a line. We're seeing like little glimpses of lines, and then but you realize it's like 10 seconds out of a, what is it, 100-second track.
Yeah, it's definitely tough because you can see even now, like the Ghost was faster in other sections, despite that he was much cleaner here because it's still just trial and error.
It's
doesn't quite get the
scrub.
This is so brutal. When is the actual, like, what's the biggest strip of straight we actually have? This
it's right there.
That was it. That's it.
That's it.
What do you think of this track, Cody?
I think I'm gutted I got eliminated, but then again.
Yeah, this is straight torture.
This is
ruthless.
Literally 16
I probably would have
owed
Simon a new phone.
Yeah. this is throwing a phone against a wall kind of track.
Zach is consistently hitting that triple off the start, which is a good sign.
Still
133,
yeah.
135.
Two
I
seconds.
Think there's what I would say on a perfect run, you're somewhere in the mid to low 20s.
Man, you can't get a perfect run on us.
Yeah, I do agree with the sentiment that you can't get a perfect run. So, look, there's the difference. Look, Zach perfectly hits that triple up over the top.
This is still like...
Tire tapping, actually, at the top of that tabletop isn't the worst thing in the world because it does
like
dust off a lot of speed.
The starting line from Zach seems to be the one. But it's where we lose it in the second.
I think by here he's lost. But he's got the start figured out, which is progress at least.
Then he's going to case.
This is when he cases it, yeah.
And
right into that.
Painful case, too, when you go into a wall.
Case again.
Found something.
Zach says he's found something, but we're watching his current replay, which still... I mean, he must get caught up quite quickly here. No, he doesn't. It's a two-second gap.
Long.
So. Bang.
I think you've got to go really short.
Yeah.
Well, we'll just whip out that red button for a bit.
I think you've got to look to land before those whoops and try and gap them. God. Question is, where do you dump the speed to get into that ramp?
That's what you wanted. That's what you wanted. I mean, I like that from the whoops. You just skip them all entirely.
But those aren't the ones. Those ones aren't as
killer.
They're
problematic, yeah.
Yeah, those ones have got a rhythm to them. It's the other ones where you're coming in, you're landing on top of them from a high height.
But isn't that what the tabletop's for? Just to land in between it?
Well,
yeah.
I think it's... right here. That's where you want to be.
Yeah,
you want to
get
into that with speed.
There you go. That's the badger. That's what you'd say if you're in Northern England.
We are not in Northern England, but I appreciate that.
Educating you. That must be... That, is that
so
quicker?
Was that the 133, was it?
I believe
so,
yeah.
Okay. So the creator of the track dropped to 144 already. We've shaved 11 seconds or 10 seconds off that.
I think there's easy that's still in it. So, yeah, he's trying to find a hole shot in there somewhere. I suppose I shouldn't use the term hole shot when it's not referring to a suspension at the start. Cody, I'm sorry. Please forgive me.
There's a lot of jargon that I have no idea what it means.
Oh. And speaking of suspensions, ride it out.
Balls through the neck.
Breaking that front tire.
Yeah, front wheel is optional. Apparently so is back, a spine.
Bonk. That would be a fun little game mode for a weekend. You get rid of the front tire, see who can go the furthest.
Yeah.
I think the man sitting next to us, I think Cody, you could probably pull that off.
Yeah, Cody and Master.
That would be a wheelie tough track.
Oh. All right. And we're going to put you down after the show. That's enough from you. Just get you on a flight to Switzerland real quick.
To Geneva to go skiing, right?
Exactly. We're going to send you to see Team Dignitas.
I see what you did there.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was very good, Tass.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know, never mind.
So they definitely got the start, which doesn't surprise me, but they're still flirting with a few different rhythms.
Yeah, you can't take too many risks.
Yeah, it's like, even if you have a good plan, which line you're going to take, there's just so much to memorize.
Yeah, I can't memorize it. It's just bumps.
Austin agrees with you. It is just bumps. So this is the section coming in, and I want to see. To be fair, I'm not seeing a lot of breaks. I'm seeing a lot of guessing in terms of rolling off the throttle. That's not. Yeah, that's. So a bit long. But definitely flirting with it.
I mean, any improvement at this point in time is could be game defining. He's already got 20 meters on his ghost.
You know what? I think they're starting to pick up that started lap two. There's about three or four spots where they've just got to figure out the line. I think we're going to get pretty close to having a line by the end of this. I changed my opinion on that. We still have 42 minutes.
Yeah.
Because you could tell they're finding the places that are struggling with them, and they're both starting to change it considerably in those spots.
Right. They have the pieces of the puzzle.
Yeah, just put it together. This is one of those puzzles that you see families do over a month.
Yeah. Yeah. Which doesn't come with one of those pictures on the cover. It's like a mystery.
Yeah.
3D mystery puzzle.
Well, the ones that are just like dots and lines, just to make it even more confusing.
That's just a blank white canvas that you put together.
Oh god, that makes that.
My mom used to love those. She was
really
quite sadistic. Yeah.
I could never do that. I haven't got the patience for puzzles.
Yeah. Satisfying when you like, there's only a few pieces left and you find it. You're like, yes, got it. But
I used to be the guy when we did puzzles that were just like, okay, you do the sky, get all the blue bits, Alex, and then we'll do the hard work.
Yeah.
Talking to blue bits, CSC in blue. It's just trying to go from that checkpoint, trying to suss out this at the second attempt. But I mean, you're going to be coming into that with more momentum than you are, right?
Wow. Cody would be the specialist on that.
Yeah,
I think if you can get consistent wheelie out of that first, that's very good.
So maybe you have to just hit the brakes before you start the second checkpoint.
Well, I think you want to... No, even the second lap?
Yeah.
I think you still want to hammer it over the first lap because you're going to have so much more speed.
Really?
Yeah.
I think we might have just had a time update because I hear Ozzy over there saying he just put in something a little bit different. We'll wait for it to go through.
No, I didn't put anything in.
I didn't put anything in, all right, but I think he found something. He sounded quite delighted.
It did, yeah.
Didn't quite pull a master where he get up from the table and look down at his phone as if the world was ending.
Disbelief, yeah.
There's only been about three finishes so far.
Yeah.
Three times in 20 minutes.
Yeah, in 20 minutes. That's actually a really good point when you look
history
at that way.
History is being written.
Whereas Bragg's dad would already have a time in.
Yeah.
He'd be under a minute.
Do you think?
Yeah.
I think so. He's quick in finding those lines.
He is.
Getting a decent run in.
Bragg's dad
with the wheelie
probably
that
got it on his phone in the green room now. If you haven't, do it now.
Maybe it's a bike seven track.
Oh, that's a good one.
Change the bike.
I wonder if you could be right, because they'll hit all these short gaps almost perfectly to land in them.
Yeah.
I challenge someone to change
imagine the bike. That was the trick. Like, yeah, roll it with bike 7, you'll be way faster.
Get master out of here on bike 7 on this track, you'll kill it.
Oof, that's an interesting thought.
I really want to see someone kill this track.
But
it would be a heck of an accomplishment.
But I feel like if you take a good time, a good line on this track, you are a hot favorite
bike 7 on my phone. Let's see what happens. I'm just gonna go Hail Mary on this.
Can you bring this track up?
Yeah, I've got it. Get out of my challenges that I keep losing first. Grab a bike here.
Go 7.
You got any rockets there?
I've got a bunch of rockets. Yeah, I definitely have a bunch of rockets.
Mm. Oh, just kisses it.
Mm. Where am I going to?
Zach, 50 meters on his ghost. Just needs to stay consistent. That's going to be hasn't lost the front wheel, though. That could have been a possibility. Still 20 meters. Looking to land it. Does just case a little bit, but he's into the second lap. Still floating. Comes down just right. And this is where he does seem to have his strengths towards the end of this one. So if he stays Mr. Consistent, maybe not. Gaps closing quite quickly with his ghost.
Yeah.
On the back wheel. And that's where he's going to get past.
All right, bike. You want bike 7?
Yeah.
So not bike number 1?
No,
that's so a farm bike.
Okay, bike 7. Play.
This should have been the championship round.
Oh, no, you wait until you see the championship round.
Is it even worse?
It might be.
Oh, goodness.
All right, fever. I think the guy that made this, Nolan, must have been having a fever and hallucinating when he made it, to be fair. It's like, oh, whoops, and then rollers, and then whoops, and more rollers.
It would make sense.
Ah, it's, you know, bike seven. Oh, why is my phone not letting me lean? There we go.
Just a quick service announcement to everyone that's joining us here to watch the World Championship on Facebook. You guys are going to perhaps have to migrate over to Twitch to continue watching this spectacular battle of skill and wits between Austin and Zach, as it is going to be coming shutting down in about 20 minutes' time due to the four-hour limit that Facebook does provide on the live stream. So do move over to Twitch. What's the full address we're broadcasting to?
live.mad.mx.
Type that in and you'll be on the website. You'll get the broadcast. That's where you should be heading. Thank you very much, Tobias.
I'm not going to lie to you. I just went way farther on bike 7 than I did on bike 11. Like, I just made it way further in the track than I ever did trying bike 11.
Does anyone want to spend 5 minutes trying bike 7?
I want to.
Austin's thinking about it.
Are you allowed to do that?
I see no reason not to.
No, I mean,
you want to do
Turborilla
it?
Gamer?
Wait in a sec.
Oh my God, they might do
just
it.
Let me know.
Wow. It's actually, the question is when you get into some of the faster sections.
All right.
Are they seriously going for it? I see him scoring. I think Austin's going for it. Can we get jump in with DJ Austin? Just want to see his perspective as he
bike
changes.
Bike 7, you ready?
Bike 7. Really? Whoops. Oh, wrong one. Oh.
Yeah, whoops.
Whoops.
Oh, wow.
Shut up. No way. There's no way.
If I get a better time on bike 7, I'm going to flip out.
You like that?
Holy hell.
No way.
The track fits bike 7 to a perfection.
Shut up, Matt.
This is ridiculous. Did you say this? Yeah. Was this you, Cody?
Yeah,
genius.
It just looks
like... Are they on bike 7 right now?
They are.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, just like one that was sitting in a storage locker for like before the game had bike 11. Joe's over there grinning ear to ear. I wonder if he knew the secret.
He knew.
If we didn't say anything,
is where it could change though, because this is where bike 7 doesn't have the guts.
Yeah,
it doesn't. So the start's definitely easier, but this is where
some sections where
I'm gonna at least do one lap and then I'll go back on bike 11.
Yeah, I think it might just be a one lap trick.
Yeah.
It looks like it just lacks so much oomph. I don't know if you can handle it on the straights.
Yeah, but look, lands on the tabletop.
Yeah. Perfect landing.
I think there's something there. I don't think it's faster, because obviously if you could figure out bike 11 it is, but it definitely fits the rhythm at the start easier.
On bike 7. Actually? Yeah.
You close. What did you say, Zach?
I'm going back.
I almost hit a quad on bike 7.
Almost hit a quad on bike 7. I don't think... you're not a fan of it. Yeah, we're going to be seeing 11 come back out.
Yeah, of course it's better to use the 11 and tap the brake here and there.
Use the brake instead, but I mean 7 does, I guess, for people like Matt.
Man, I'm shocked at how much faster I am on 7.
But the 11 is going to shoot like a cannon out of those holes in a way that the 7 can't do.
How many guesses that they get back on 11 and instantly wheelie out of the start and crash because they're like, oh wait, acceleration again. That's what that feels like.
It's got so much kick to it.
I did at least one lap on bike 7. That was fun.
Did you?
Yeah, I finished at least a lap at...
What was your time on it? What was the time, ZSE? Yes.
Huh?
What was your bike 7 time? Was it close?
It didn't show,
okay.
Whenever you don't improve your time, it won't show.
Okay. 133, though, is your current.
But I'm guessing I was probably 140 meters behind.
Okay. So, in the second half, it definitely struggles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'd probably say...
The start's easier, though, isn't it?
I like the theory.
Probably 145.
You need a button where you can just switch bikes halfway through.
Oh, yeah.
Like a little pit stop.
Yeah. Just have like a manually removing restrictor plate. You just reach down and rip it out. So back on bike 11, Austin throwing it huge. What is that, like a quadruple? A sextet?
I don't know what that was.
Yeah, doing that on bike 6.
That was a case anyway.
Yeah, that's a case, yeah. All that good work, it's come undone.
And we're almost halfway.
Well, that's the thing. I was just about to say that. We're almost halfway. You're to the point now where every time you're beating your Yost, finish it. Just get it done. And that's what Austin does there. So he's going to improve ever so slightly. I think it's just enough where we're going to be both within the 133s right now.
That's 134, I think.
Was it 134? Okay, well, we're getting closer, no less.
Well, we can give him a little bit of additional pressure.
Yeah, he's going to try and hit this again. Down over, case up.
Not happening.
Drop into the first hole. Austin going to shoot it up, try and hit the triple. Does make it into, well, relatively smooth. But then the problem is he goes a little bit deep, cases it out, and that's going to mean he can't wheel tap. I still think the wheel tap down over that drop is going to be the fastest. They just touch it on the way by. It's going to throw the bike at an angle. They're going to make it down in quite easy. Goes deep again.
Problems encountered already.
He's going to stick to it because he knows there's lots of room for improvement elsewhere. Goes for it, but again, comes up shallow because he didn't quite get the same roll into that hole shot. Whatever we want to call it, Death Alley seems to be catching a lot of people off.
Still, though, he can close this gap.
And perfect wheelie out of that. And does the seat bounce. So this is why he's sticking with these runs at this point. We're down to 30 minutes, I think, just about.
Still cases it, but he's still got 10 meters on his ghost, but then flying past him.
Gets up in the air, but this is where he comes into the whoops. Doesn't quite get onto the tabletop. Does manage to get his wheel down. That first ghost didn't make it onto that first tabletop, so he made up some speed.
That's the scrub.
And lap two. And this is where you, whatever this is, six tet, quad, triple, whoa, into some motors. I think that's time for the reset.
Yeah.
So they've definitely got the first section figured out to a point. That's much better from Austin. Now, okay, we snapped off. I was hoping to get that wheel tap because that'll drop him right into the hole.
Can go take a visit from Canada down to the U.S. into Zachary POV.
Simon, this track is insane.
I think Zach should have taken his family motocross park, and they should build this track so he can go practice.
No, everyone would die at the track.
Everybody would die. Our lawsuits and legal battles would go way through the roof. Just make them sign a waiver that says ride at your own risk. Everything's fine then.
I mean, cleaning the blood would be a problem.
Nah, it's dirt. You just kick it in.
Okay.
This is your track, Zach, with your fever.
This is Zach's track.
Yeah, he's a little under the weather today. I'd say he's under the timetable right now.
Just getting that start. This is where you can mimic your ghost just a little bit. He is going to be trying to find an edge. And
so there. Oh, see, look at his ghost. His ghost actually goes quad off the start.
Yeah.
And then just catches the wheel at the top of the tabletop. So one, two, three, in, down, and watch. Just touch, throws him over, and down he goes. And he gets
that's
it
what you
perfectly.
Want. That's the wheel tap you're talking about.
Yeah.
You have to get that so smooth, though, if you want to clear it right out.
Yeah. That's hard.
But, I mean, the fact that he's...
That you or me, does it actually a clear run on this track?
Oh, it's not happening.
I don't know if we've had any time updates. 133-1, 134.8, 30 minutes. We're about to hit the halfway point.
It would be really fun to see all of the 12 riders on this track just to see the time differences.
Yeah.
Should have been the first track.
Should have been the first track.
Yeah. Yeah, weed out the men from the boys. Really.
Yeah, I mean, you open the tournament with this track, you've got a lot of unhappy campers.
That works.
That works good.
You got a bit of a gap on the way down, but it's
Everyone
still all right.
Gone back to the room and played Doodle Jump.
Yeah, Doodle Jump. God, I remember wasting history lessons in that with that game.
Ah, man. Cell phone games. Tetris ruined my math career in high school.
See, I was a bejeweled man myself. Bang.
Well, at least he adapted to the fact that he wasn't going to make it over that, but he's still chasing
he's
the ghost.
He's still got a line.
There's that halfway mark.
That is a scary halfway goal.
Ooh, this could be... He's going to stick with it. At this point, like we're saying, halfway, we're not seeing much improvement over a very long, hard to memorize track. Yeah. Just get them in.
Try and get that time down.
So it goes triple this time instead. Not going to give him that same wheel tap, but gets down there quite efficiently. I think you could, if you go triple, the line could let you wheel tap the backside of the tabletop maybe and get down. Or is it too steep an angle?
Yeah, that's the problem. It's so steep, you've kind of got to slow down for it to get that backside smooth.
What do you do,
it's so hard.
Slow down.
I like that they're still talking it through together, trying to solve it together, despite there being so much competition on the line.
Well, I think if they had the track figured out, you wouldn't see any of that. But they're both so confused and so lost still in this situation. So we're going to bow Tobias out. Thanks for joining us. I think you're seeing your physics
you
in full
Tobias.
Effect on this map.
You're definitely making the players sweat with this one, for sure.
Yeah.
I blame your physics, definitely.
I think you're onto a gem of a game, though. This thing's pretty cool. And we're definitely seeing some incredible riders this weekend. This is the ghost side by side. So drop it into that hole with the wheel tap. They both actually got it pretty smooth, but it carries them over. There's where it makes a difference. You get so much more speed, no case, into the first set of whoops. And, well, then it's just
It's just case two.
Yeah.
Bang, bang, bang.
This is
agonizing.
Are you kind of glad you're sitting here right now with us? Have you spotted a line? Anything that they could do?
Not
or are
there.
You still not?
Yeah. No.
You'd be falling into the same traps.
Yeah. I'm curious to know if anyone in the green room has already spotted
it. They could be playing, they just can't post a time yet. That's what's interesting, is they could probably have a little idea.
Yeah, they're not allowed to finish times because it'll go onto our timesheet by accident.
But they can be having a little doodle.
So dropped in hard in that death alley we talked about. We made it back up over top of the triple, and he's got way better momentum on second run. There's where he's going to lose it. Makes it into that, and he probably lands backside of here, I would think. That would bring him down.
Goes high.
Now this puts him low, which that might change it. I was going to say, this should put him low for the whoops.
I don't know.
Well, yeah, in the place of Tobias, Joe has rejoined us. Mark, first question to you is, what on earth are you seeing?
This is insane. There actually is a line through here.
There is confirmation.
There is a definite line. I have confirmation.
Have you seen it?
I've seen it. I've done it maybe
done
once.
It. Do we have evidence of
it? I haven't done it in two laps. I've only done it first lap.
What kind of time are you looking at if you get the line right?
I have no idea because I've only done it on a single. We had it single lap at first, so I was doing it on a single lap, and then we decided to be mean and make it two laps.
Yeah, you're very mean.
So. I think mean is a under.
One lap would have been a lot better.
You know what? This track wasn't even made for this event. What happened was this guy Nolan sent me this track, and it was actually supposed to go in the regular game, and I was playing with it, testing it, and I was like,
"This is not.
Dude, this is insane. Yeah. Like, this is brutal. This is perfect for the world championship." So I told him, and he was stoked to have it in the world championship.
Well, congrats to Nolan, but I mean, you can see the damage you are doing to these two human beings here. They're playing for thousands of dollars on your map, or your track, do excuse me, and where are we on the timesheet? I mean, we are what?
Oh, for time left?
Yeah.
26. We are well over halfway.
Well over halfway.
We haven't seen much improvement.
I think we've seen how many times? Like 3 or 4 times posted in total?
That's it.
Yeah.
Well, if you finish the whole track, it's only like 40, 50 attempts.
Yeah.
Full finishes.
So. That's a good point. Yeah. I think at this point you got to start just throwing some times in.
Yeah.
I mean, within reasonable doubt, if your ghost is still in vision,
go.
Or if you know your ghost made a mistake somewhere ahead of you, just keep going.
Yeah. It's still quite close too.
Very close.
I think the hardest part of this track is coming in on the second lap and landing in the right spot to set yourself up for lap two.
Yeah.
I mean, that's I don't think I've seen a perfect lap one yet.
My front wheel would get rubbed off.
The second lap, and you're where you're going.
And how do you rate this compared to the final track, Joe?
I don't know. The difference between this and the final track is this track has way more line options. There's more you can do. So I think it's hard when you have so many options because you're like, which one do I take? But the next one's pretty bad.
Oh, man. He keeps casing that. Is that where you want to throw short, Cody? Be safe? Because you can easily get into the one before it, whereas that's more of a risk to try and make it.
You've got to get that backside perfect to clear that corner.
That's something from Austin.
He's got the start down.
Yeah, this looks
he
nice.
He goes, I think...
But I think at the moment, showboat, it's about just finding the safest line and just finishing.
I mean, playing it safe is probably going to be the name of the game, right? Yeah. I mean...
Just crossing the line.
Crossing the line and not crashing is probably step one in picking this one up. I think it's gonna like you said, the likelihood of a crash in our winning time is probably not too ridiculous of a concept.
This first section is really tough. This is the section that gives me
because you kind of come in straight on that.
Because right here you have to have perfect throttle control. Because if you go a little too far, you're not gonna make that you just made.
Oh, that's a wipeout.
I was jumping the whole thing.
Santa. Supposed to be good at flying, but not so much.
He's trying to come to town. He just can't quite make it across the line.
Yeah.
He knows
that's where I thought maybe you could backside wheel tap that, but I don't think you can. Seeing it with that much speed.
I wish I could.
You'd have to be hard on the brake to do it.
I wish I could give it away, but.
Do it. Do it right now.
It's terrible.
I dare you. You won't.
Do it, please.
I don't know what Zach's doing, but
won't.
I don't know.
I'm doing nothing.
You're going to go and try this?
So, do you guys want me to talk about the lines here or no?
No, keep it a secret, honestly. Right. Then just tell us.
Okay, I won't say anything.
Keep it a secret.
Unless you both, agree, I'm not saying anything.
Just whisper in my ear.
Yeah. What did you think about the bike 7 try?
That was kind of funny.
You like that?
And for cool. The first, like this first section, it was like perfect, and then after that, it was useless.
However, I would like to know once we get on the couch, if you don't mind.
Oh, for sure.
We can even show you. What about the phone?
Oh God, for me to show them the right line on this will take me hours.
Yeah. It's all right. We have a couple of hours.
I should sit here right now while they're playing and see if I can see if I can throw it on a hard one.
I love that. I mean,
Cody's already done that. He's already pulled his phone out.
There is no eSport that I've ever kind of commentated where you have people playing the game on the analyst desk. Welcome to mobile gaming.
I'm going to be really stoked if Cody beats them.
That would be interesting.
I can't even do this first little step down.
That's properly. A really tough line. Jeez. Austin seems to have perfected the start.
I see what you're trying to do.
That's the line. Did you see it?
Roughly. Is that a... I'm going to watch. I think I know what you did.
Man, I can't make that. Do you stop at the top of the drop?
Mm-hmm. I get what you're doing. I can't say anything about what you're doing. Right now, what these two are doing is ghosting it out. Austin's still battling it with his evil self.
Yeah.
His dark twin nemesis. And they're both making the same mistakes. Austin, you gotta learn by now, bro.
I know, I don't know.
Where's your repetitive memory process thing, whatever they call that?
It's not working.
Definitely.
We haven't seen a shift in times in about 25 minutes now.
This is a struggle. This is,
This is brutal. If anyone's joined us and is unfamiliar, what on earth is on the line in this particular 60-minute segment? One of these players will be going home in fourth place, taking home 1,600.
Oh,
the other will
close.
Have a chance to go ahead and take 7. ZSE, Zachary Elms, has been doing a fantastic job in this tournament. Top 3 consistently alongside the Norwegian.
Finally,
that's
something.
A finish.
I think we
something
need
from
that's
ZSE,
an
and
well.
That's an improvement.
I think there's some scrubbing that can be done.
That took so long.
Is that a big sigh of relief?
Yeah.
Does that feel
I know
nice?
I can improve.
No.
I think that there's a couple scrubs available in that midsection.
What'd you get?
That would buy some space.
Well, in the words of TLC.
Tell me your time, I'll tell you what I just got.
No, was it under 130?
No. Okay. I barely improved it.
I'll give it to you because we got time left. 20 minutes, I'm not going to say much more than this. Minute 32 sevens where we're at. We're still got Struggle City everywhere.
And what is second place
What'd
this
you
time?
Say, 132 seven?
Yeah.
Want to refresh it?
You want to refresh it, DJ Ozzy?
As soon as we mention Ozzy, he always says it. 132-2. They're both set neck and neck.
That was a...
And we got to replay it. Is this... I wonder if this...
I think this is
replays.
It. No, wait, we're going to bring
him up right now. As soon as you were talking about Zach beating it, I literally just beat it.
Let's get that one. Let's
get always
that.
Happens with you.
Oh, we won the head-to-head.
Head. We got to click them both real quick. Boom, boom, nailed it.
This is it, then. The current head-to-head.
So really straightforward. Both of them down into that bottom ball at the start, but very different there. So double... Or
watch
triple, I guess,
second,
versus quad. Double
line.
Wheel tap, it's but he makes it in.
The lines kind of correlate, though, look.
Yeah, they do to an extent, but it was much smoother.
From Austin?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But look at how little difference it makes in the second half.
Will just say I improved my time by 9 seconds, and I'm catching up to you guys. So wow. I'm going to put myself in the final round if I beat you.
Yeah.
That definitely.
How many minutes do we got here?
You can only have one TCR finalist anyway, so neither of these guys can be there.
TCR taking over. And they are just
cases.
Neck and I love this from DJ Austin, just a little too long.
Cody, I think at this point where you're casing all the back of those in the last half of the lap,
smoother.
Do you just want to aim short from this point? Do you just say, let's do a lap where I aim short and everything, I roll everything?
Yeah.
Look at that look, that was a scrub and a half.
What
the, where did the speed come from?
Now I'm seeing where you
made
up the time.
Yeah, did you see that?
Yeah, you just teleported.
That's definitely... the line on the entry to the second lap.
It looked like he used a rocket. That's all I'm saying.
It's too bad you suck everywhere else, but you know.
Yeah, just get.
I don't know. I'm playing my own right now.
He's
I'm
playing
too
his
busy.
Own to beat you guys.
That's
oh,
nice.
Is that the prettiest time?
You just posted
but
a new one.
It is definitely a huge improvement.
Zach has submitted a new time.
Oh, right. We're getting into the neck
He's
and neck where they start.
Oh my goodness!
Oh, that's a massive improvement. 128.3.
Actually.
And we're getting,
actually,
we're getting into the section of it where they're stopping, helping each other, and they're just taunting each other with time. So this is
what we were
off.
Expecting to happen. The teamwork
Dude,
is
I
over.
I got so lucky into the second lap. I hit it perfectly.
Zach's saying he got lucky in the second lap. I'd love to bring that up if
Austin
we can.
Austin had a great entrance to the second lap as well. The rest of it was just awful.
We have to see that. Let's have a look at ZSC and his lucky start.
You are
second.
Right behind them, Joe.
I'm trying hard here.
I love how you're tripling that first one, Joe.
It's like B. Coop over the back. Again.
It's not B. Coop over there. It's not the guy who got you.
So we're getting to see Zach's lines here, and it does look a lot smoother than what we started with.
Massive start.
Wow. Whoa. Look at
yeah,
that
I
skip.
Did a pretty good start.
Back tire just getting a lot of the action.
Still could be improved there if he hits the back side of that landing. Gets a little more speed in.
And that's another.
Pretty clean.
Little case.
Lovely.
Second left.
Has to sacrifice that.
But I mean, he's already got me on the edge of my seat because he's saying that that second lap start was luck. I kind of look forward to seeing how that luck did manifest itself.
Well, we're about to find out. Cross the line.
Here it comes. Big... Says he did it perfect. Let's keep an eyes on the screen. Oh, and it is just smooth enough.
Oh, but see, he went down
that deceleration,
hole,
though.
Whereas Austin actually gapped that. I think he was definitely faster for the first bit of that lap, but there's still definitely some time on that. I think we 24s.
24?
I think 24s would be a jam time.
Definitely. Maybe even 20.
Ooh. Oh!
That's kind of nifty.
It's worked out well. And another one just into the bumpy whoop stuff.
Joe, with a track like this, do you kind of just like place jumps in random places, or do you have an idea?
No, these most of the track designers are purposely placing everything. Like, there's usually nothing that's just random. Okay. It's all totally.
Would you reverse build? You'd build the line first and then add in
sometimes
stuff to throw you off.
Yeah, sometimes you can do that too, and you just add like weird stuff in between to just
mess
throw
people
off. Yeah.
Oh man,
that seems like an easy way to build a map. Maybe not the most effective, but. Build a really simple line and then just throw everything in between.
With two lap tracks, it gets tricky. Usually you make the first lap and then you go through and you test it the second lap, and it usually throws you into a weird space.
Zach, he's got a razor out. He just keeps shaving.
This is getting pressure on because we're at 15 minutes, and we've seen how much time is bled away with these guys still hunting.
This is the first time we've seen ZSC in that lower bracket. The first time he's fallen. DJ Ozzy has been here before. He's been defending himself.
I think it's the aerodynamics of that beard that's slowing Austin down.
Yeah, the aerodynamics of the Santa hat.
Yeah.
I hit a certain secret line twice.
I think we should stop talking times now and let the players do it themselves.
That's Austin if he can pin that clean. If he can pin that clean. Yeah, I did see it. I saw you break your spine into a million pieces too.
It's that secret Santa line.
Yeah, Secret Santa.
Secret Santa.
Reddit Secret Santa.
Did you see Bill Gates did a Reddit Secret Santa this
My
year?
Sister did it. She always gets dope stuff. She got a wicked Game of Thrones like beer stein. It says winter is coming on it. I was like, I'm going to steal that.
Drink out of the Iron Throne.
The Iron Mug.
Not happening. Did we decide how the meters transfer into seconds? Has someone done that for us?
It's all relative to speed at the direct moment. 1 meter could be 1 second if they're going slow. It could be less than that if they're flying along.
I just nailed the line there. I'm coming to you guys.
I normally find that around 20 meters is about a second.
About a second?
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. So if you have like that 18 or 15 meters on yourself, you're going to be Gucci. I just said Gucci. Who am I?
Definitely has that down.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
That's the flying. And then you just breeze past these two wheels on the track.
This is where you're going to sacrifice a little bit.
It's a small price to pay, though, Matt. Look at this go.
I still think there's a better line that's going to get you over some of that. But at this point, forget better lines. Take best possible line.
TJ Ozzy Austin's trying to make a big time here. He does encounter a problem. I hear a wail of disgust. And wow, he's lost 30 meters on himself there. He is going to put his forehead into the dirt.
And he's like to go for the double every time off the start. He drops him in perfect.
I love that line. That's the start.
But here's where I think there's definitely room for improvement. After these whoops,
whoa.
I think there's a line here? In here. This is better. This is my. That's what he didn't get last time.
That's
he didn't
what
get
you're
down
into there. He goes for the. Is it going to be a double? Well,
I
just
think he tried
about.
To slow himself up to hit that. He just barely made it.
Things are starting to come together. Things are correlating here. These whoops where he lost. This is where he lost his mitts before. He's going to keep it. He just about keeps himself on the track. 30 meters now.
That's a heart and throat moment. Both those scrubs that, though, as a result.
Okay.
But that's going to lose. Now, how much speed did he lose going into lap two? Because remember, he had a line. Then that's exactly it.
Oh,
doesn't get it. Cases. And it won't put him into this. He's got to drop down. He's already behind it. But he can repeat the first lap now almost to a tee. Yep, there you go. Because I did say he got that start right on his ghost. That was easily
hot
potential
pursuit.
For his best run.
Hot pursuit, though. Hot pursuit. Anything is a bonus at this point in time. How has he come back from this?
Look at this. Is he gonna? Is he gonna hit the
throws
quad?
In the style?
Oh,
DJ Ozzy has somehow managed to chase his ghost. Where did this come from?
Can he land on the flat section?
He's
that's
on the
huge.
Flat.
That's big.
On the back wheel.
Oh boy.
30 meters, and he's gonna keep the gap. He's extending it, going back to the 50 meter territory.
Nails it over top of the table. That's gonna be up there. That's gonna be close. Zach's gone into 27.9. Ozzy 29.2. Oh,
okay.
He's made a massive improvement.
That's a big
and. If he doesn't mess up the start to the second lap, I think he's got
it. We have to look at ZSE's run now. We have to see where that 27 came from.
That was impressive.
This is the head-to-head. Let's get a little compare and contrast.
It's not the chairs that start hurting your back. It's the pressure on your shoulders right now.
So they're both hitting that front line now correctly, it looks like. I can say that since they're both doing it.
This is the head-to-head sudden death. 60 minutes to determine your
fate.
That is where I think there's room for improvement right there.
Really? So you don't think you drop into that?
No. I don't know, though. Zach makes it look good, so maybe you do.
I think you take seat bounce, don't you? Off the top of the table.
I like the
Oh, okay, yeah. I was going to say bring the mic up. I was like, maybe not.
Jumping up to which rollers? Oh, from the bottom. So you land on the table.
Ooh, yeah. He's got a lot of room for improvement there.
This track, I mean, it's a love-hate thing, isn't it?
This.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah, a little
bit,
just
but
still
one, I mean.
Good enough to keep the rhythm. But I think right here you need to land on, and then
right.
onto there, and then that'll automatically launch you to that landing.
Which is
and
where you want to be.
A lot of time.
It's a lot of airtime for Zach.
He does get over this, well, as soon as I say it.
Because what you want to do is land down in that dip, which launches you up, which will land you perfectly
I almost
right want to
make
there.
This like a two-hour
yeah.
round, just
that
so we
seemed,
can see
that, that part seemed obvious to me at the start, but what wasn't obvious was how you got down into that with effectiveness.
Yeah. It's just crazy that how many mistakes are in that, and that's the winning run right now.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's crazy you can run like that and still have a two-second lead
yeah.
when you almost come into a stop.
man.
Austin was definitely better in certain sections, too, so.
Still 10 minutes left on the clock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why is that go?
Oh, here's an improvement.
This could be this.
Oh, it's only first lap.
Yeah, but much better run into the first lap. Remember, that's where he lost it last
style
time.
Style points.
Style points, and he's not going to be having
this,
the same
this,
problems.
Oh,
he's gone and lost the wheel.
I think if you get perfection into the second lap with maybe even a wheelie across the top, you'll make that. If you don't make that, you got to sacrifice
perfect
it and drop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's worth it right there.
No more times and names, boys. It's the last 10 minutes.
On a scale of one to pressure, I'm pretty sure you could crush Colin to a diamond
sweaty.
Over there.
Yeah. This is what we call in England squeaky bum time.
Yeah. Well, you guys have a lot of different names for squeaky bum time in England.
Yeah.
Well, means a few different things, especially when Henry and you are around.
Absolutely. Austin and Zachary, man, clashed head to head. The two teenagers of the tournament alongside Mr. Bragg's dad in the finals. You're 20 now. Happy birthday. Well, it's time to get you an extra birthday present if you can win this one.
It's getting to the point where it's just going to be a Hail Mary.
Mm-hmm. I'm still excited that I improved my time by 9 seconds. No one seems to care about that.
It's not all about you, Joe.
Joe Mama's so narcissistic.
Oh, man.
That's the problem. If you don't land down in that hole correctly,
yeah.
you
have
don't.
To have max speed in that little hole.
Max speed in the hole, Alex. Remember that.
I will.
Are you going in again, Cody? Ah, I thought Cody was busting that out again. Well, it's 10 minutes to deciding who our third finalist is out of the lower bracket. TCR, I interestingly used to be in a clan called the Canadian Rifles, and we do have a Canadian Rifle in this, but I think he's shooting blanks right now.
The Canadian Rifles, baby.
I like how they're starting to mess with each other a bit over there.
Trying to throw him off. It's not just the gameplay, it's also the fact that you are right there in front of your opponent. Can't see his screen, but you know he is on that same track, working those same lines.
That's looking good.
Yeah, looking very nice.
Get there. Oh,
just a little.
I think it's about efficiency at the start. Like you said, looks good, looks wheelie. It changes the speed so much. Just get into the whole first part is about getting into that hole.
Yeah, that's it. But you can't full throttle all these little things because it messes you up.
What the
hell? He's throwing Hail Marys.
Oh my gosh.
That is unreal.
Don't stop.
Now you got to hold it together though, bro.
Don't stop.
Interesting choice, but that works.
It has worked. Problem's going to be encountered here, though.
Yep. This is still wet. Good.
Oh, man.
This game just keeps on giving.
Oh, this is the perfect line if he can get there.
Oh, it's close.
Still. Oh, recover. It's gone. It's gone. Hit the brakes. Santa Claus has got brakes.
He's pulled his reins back.
Yeah.
He's looking away from the
stage. The problem is, he's lost so much going into this. He's got to go back to the old line.
Come away.
You're
from
dead right.
Time.
He nailed that line.
He's so good that while he's in air, he looks away and looks at us to give us reactions and then goes back to playing mid-run.
Oh.
Someone needs to...
Even just getting out of that first one, I hold my breath at times because we know... Oh, too far.
And so looking to do better on the second lap.
I feel like if we had 2 hours on this track, these guys would...
I think they get it.
To find the line in 2 hours on this track is just absolute madness.
I think as well, listening to some of the people in the other room, the other riders that were in this, I think they're earning respect for how much they're going through in this track. Like, they might be struggling to find the line, but my God.
They're getting a lot of love from in the other room. But, I mean, it's a mutual respect thing.
Almost too far, huh?
I think it's deep. That's what I'm saying. I mean, too much at the start is...
There's no room for error down in there.
I think this is going to be too much. Yeah. Oh, but that's a way to do it.
Where did that come from? What's our time?
5 minutes.
Five minutes.
That's about two or three full times.
Oh, my God.
Two or three attempts, ladies and gentlemen.
Austin's going to hit this again. Try and get a little deeper in that double. This could slow him off, though. Yep, this could be fine. In, nails it.
That's what you needed.
Just throw in the bike.
Yep.
Slight case, but ride this out. Maybe. He's comfortable. Definitely can't.
That's booty to the ground. DJ Ozzy, a bit of a newcomer to the scene. He's taken everyone by surprise in the jams and has continued to do so here in Stockholm.
I think this is one of the ones now where you start to forget your ghost is there. You know roughly what you've got to do. Ignore he exists and just get the job done.
Yeah.
You know where you need to land.
It's like a poltergeist at this point. Don't even know what that means.
That's
just being
lovely
vague.
That you've used it.
Yeah.
Cody, no one's gone for my backflip start that I thought was brilliant.
Maybe that's what the problem is.
Yeah. I think you dismissed that idea immediately when I showed it
to
you.
Ooh, that's going to be nice.
Yeah, he's made
lots
that easy.
Lots of speed going into those whoops.
Keeps it together.
Comfortable.
Little stop up, gets caught, but that's okay because he's going to roll him where he needs to anyway.
It's okay, he's going to hit the same line he hit with this ghost. That was clean.
Nails
the quad.
Oh. Woof. The question is, where's the quad put him for the lineup that he needs?
That's okay. He's still good.
Yep.
Landing flat.
End of the world.
A little deep, but he can cover. He can cover. And again, every run matters. No. So just get it done.
Land on top.
Stable.
It works.
He's stable on the table.
Where's he going to land?
That's insane.
Oh,
he gets it to it as well. Now here's the hard part. Does he gap it?
Oh.
This could be huge. This could be massive, Austin. He's got to find a line, though. He's got to make sure he gets it clean because he's already a little bit ahead of it. Suspension gets kicked up. Case is out twice. Gets back into it. Got to find a rhythm.
Sweaty palms, but 60 meters on his ghost.
This is where he's got to find. You can hear people in the other room even hearing it. Gets down low. Does he find the line back into the... Whoops. Case out. Doesn't matter. Slow it down. Keep
Stockholm
his composure.
Holds its breath.
He comes in a little deep on the run up to it, but
it's coming down to 20 meters. He can still hold this off. Patience is a virtue at this point in time. And now, remember, he landed top of the table this time. He wants to backside it and roll this to the finish.
That's what he
wants.
That's
an improvement. Is it going to be enough, though?
127.9 he has to beat. We can't talk times, though.
Oh, my God. This is the closest thing we've ever seen. This is unbelievably close. We're talking about the hardest track all day. It took these guys almost 50 minutes to find it, and we have the closest gap on the leaderboard I think we've had all day.
This is insane.
That is unbelievable.
I don't believe it.
Do we even have time for a replay of these two? With 3 minutes left, exactly
3 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, 3 minutes.
Slight difference.
That's enough for two full runs.
So this is where I think Austin makes up the time, because he actually gets slower into the, that did it. But then it changes because he hit these whoops and Speedy Gonzales.
You've got to be careful with our results, but for sure.
Yeah, but there's differences. The line is very similar, though. That's one thing I have to say is these guys definitely found it or found something.
They found
or not
something
it's
for sure. Wow.
Yeah. There's still so many mistakes in both runs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
The weird thing is you say there's so many mistakes. It's like one or two mistakes that get compound.
Yeah.
Because it throws you off so much, it just they add up until you can get back on your rhythm.
Oh, that was insane right there.
the fact that he got two wheels.
As soon as you stuff up once, it's hard to get your rhythm back.
In the middle of Death Valley with your head facing the ground and you managed to
bounce. That seat bounce.
That's ridiculous how close these two are.
It was that pressure towards the end of the run.
This is where we're going crazy. We're getting hype, and he's just like, keep it together, keep it. And look at this. We're coming into the finish, and he's, that's unreal.
So close, anyway.
And then Zach.
Please, that's all we can say right now.
I think I can.
Don't say
I
it again.
I can. I think I
Oh, my God.
Hold on to your
what
hats.
A finish.
Hold on to your hats.
Oh, my God. We are into a minute and 26. The runs they are on right now are the runs they will finish with.
Oh, I love this.
This is it. Phones go down if a reset comes
That's
in here.
Right.
We'll jump in, see who we can follow on this.
See, maybe. See, you get that one more. Maybe see what Ozzy's up to.
That's, I can't believe that. It's funny how they're so consistent in their mistakes as well. They're both making similar issues.
Oh, my God. Who would have thought how close it would be?
Right?
Oh, wouldn't have pegged that.
Never. I mean, I wouldn't have been surprised if we saw like a 1-2 second gap, but.
And both of them right now. Okay, so Austin's up. Both were chasing the ghost on the last run.
This is one or two.
But Zach's playing this out smartly.
This is one.
Because he's going to chase the ghost and go for everything. It doesn't matter. He knows there's mistakes. He knows it's available, but goes down. He definitely had a better line into that, too. That would have passed his own ghost. And with the ghosts being basically inside of each other at the finish line, that would have been a fair bet. But we've got a finalist, and both these guys worthy on what has been the hardest track all day.
All tournament.
All tournament.
100%.
That's been the hardest track in Mad Skills Motocross history.
The hardest track in Mad Skills Motocross history, and I cannot wait to have the players on the couch to watch that replay. That's it. That's time, folks. Down.
Was amazing.
Amazing. Sixfootseven's out of here. We are going to be getting them.
Cody's already up. He doesn't even want to give his thoughts. He's already told us that he hates that map. He's like, let these guys in. Like
Canada versus USA.
Wow.
Sit down. Get that bum rested.
Oh, man. Oh, man. That was probably the most amount of pressure you guys have had all day, I would say. That was ridiculous.
I mean, okay. So we aren't going to show that replay immediately, but first, hardest track in Mad School Motocross history, Zach?
I believe so. That track was insane. I could not find a single line that was fast.
Not once? I mean, you must have got like glimpses of a line.
Yeah, I found a couple of lines, I couldn't execute them as well as I wanted to. But yeah, this is probably the hardest track I've ever done in my life.
But could you find some fun in it? Or was that pressure just too much to even
the
think about fun?
The pressure was too much for it to be fun, in my opinion.
Just all eyes on you, all eyes on that, the prize as well. Does that feel like some of the most pressure you've kind of experienced in your competitive gaming history?
I believe so. Yeah, this was a lot of pressure on me, but I had a lot of fun. And
good.
I can't wait to see who won.
This is going to be so good. I cannot wait to watch that one with you. I have to jump in. DJ Ozzy, my man, the man in the Santa hat. How was that for you?
That was terrible. I hated every minute of that.
You hated every minute.
You had a smile on your face the whole time. What are you talking about?
I don't know. It's an angry smile.
It was so hard.
So hard.
Nolan's a little devil, isn't he?
Do you know what I think you should do? You should just throw this in as a jam week for these guys only.
Yeah.
For these 12, just to see what would happen with
I would
week.
Love to see
just
where we
ended
that.
Just to see what's capable on that track.
That would be cool.
So what did you, Joe, what was your time when you were fine? You shaved 9 seconds off your time. What
I think I ended up with like a 135.
Okay. Oh, I can't wait to see the winner of this one. I'm jumping at the bit to introduce it.
Yeah. I think Austin won by just a little bit.
We haven't got the mic for him,
I think Austin won.
Okay.
Even if he did, I'm really happy with the position I got. I was hoping for top five.
Well, don't speak too soon, man.
Yeah, don't speak too soon. This is like...
zip your lip.
If you didn't put slow-mo on... I don't think you'd know who had it.
Yeah. Honestly, you are going to enjoy this one. I can't wait to see your reactions. We're going to have to keep cutting
really,
in and out.
Really excited to see
but,
what happens.
I mean, it's ready. I've had word it's ready, so sit up.
I'm not going to say anything. I just want you two to interact with
Put
this.
The mic in between you two, and let's get into this.
I don't want to see this.
Blue versus green.
Hey, this was the line I figured out. That was probably the only line that I figured out.
And that's about where the consistencies end.
Dang.
Look at the air.
Yeah, none of these.
You're
going
to have to put it by your
so
mouth, I think,
slow.
To get
these
to hear you both.
So slow.
Well, this is where, up to this point, you guys had something figured out. This is where it gets a little sloppy. Boom, case. Boom, case. Boom, case. But
what the heck is
that's
that?
Key, because and you overshot that. You want to land on that table.
My favorite part's coming up in just a moment. Look at this! What is
that? That's insane.
Nice
backspin.
So lucky. Yeah. DJ, you just go to like rocket mode.
Perfect landing into the second lap.
That this was big because you gapped that.
I didn't even think about doing that. Nice.
I did not try to do that.
Well, because I think you did try it earlier and failed. Well, yeah, so I was impressed you went for the risk.
And this was cool. Bearing in mind, this was very close to the end of the time. And this was like, what, 10 minutes left?
Back.
Look who Mr. Blue.
I know where you got me. I messed up on the final whoops and almost ate it.
Yeah, look at that.
But look at the gap, though.
What is that?
No,
Zach,
you think you messed
slam
up. Into the wall.
Yeah, you think you messed up with the final whoops.
Zach holding the front. Look at this on his nose.
But
look at how close this is, guys.
Coming in just a bit more speed across the line.
And I will go back because you know his road. That's where you lost your little bit of speed to hit the backside.
Yeah, since he was behind me, I knew that that was where he was going to get me because I almost ate it, but I decided to go for it.
But I mean, that was the time was what? Can we get them up? I mean, it was
0.13, I think.
Was it?
So it wasn't quite the hundredth of a second we had on the slower track, but on that track, when you spread out the distance, that's as close as you can get.
127.8, 127.9.
Okay, there was like a minute left or 2 minutes left, and you're literally like, okay, 127.9 is the time to beat. And I looked at my time, and I got 127.8, and I was like, no way.
No way.
We were all freaking out.
We were.
That was insane.
I could hear that. That was sweet.
That was awesome. That was what this was all about. This was what this World Championship was all about, is a game like that. You both hated the track. You both overcame adversity. And I mean, a couple
and
of
I just got to say, Canada beat USA. So, hey. Just kidding. You played well, too.
No,
it was
good.
Good
job.
But I mean, that's going to give you a chance for the grand finals. That 1600 take home pay for you, my man. We'll give the mic over to Mr. Zach. Just go ahead and say your dues. You've come in and you've kind of shut down all of those accusations. People called you a bot. They said, you know, do it offline. And you've come here to Stockholm. You've taken home fourth. Quite the achievement.
Yeah, I'm really happy with my position. Like I said, top five is what I wanted. Boom. So getting fourth, really happy with that. This track, though, it was so difficult.
Yeah.
Could have made top three, but messed up at the end, but it's okay.
Those little errors. I bet you're just chomping at the bit to have another go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I would love to have an extra 5 minutes or 10 minutes and see what I could do.
Right. I mean, this is what we were saying. We're like, if only there was 2 hours of that track just to see what happened.
I think you guys would have honed it in a lot tighter with 2 hours.
Yeah, well, and I think this was probably the only track where we saw improvements in the last 10 minutes.
Yeah.
In most tracks, we may have saw one person get another run in, but everyone kind of had it figured out by 30 minutes.
We saw a leader change in the last couple minutes,
which was
insane.
And the decibels in Stockholm raised just a little bit.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, so you can't even play cash games, and now you leave Stockholm, a visit to Europe, and 1600 in the back pocket. So a big congratulations to you.
All right, thank you very much.
No, awesome. We're going to have to steal you for the grand final.
Yeah, you get to join us for that
now.
You
up for that?
All right, yeah, I'm really excited. That's going
to
be a lot of fun
to watch. DJ Ozzy, we have to hear from you, mate, because you are in the grand finals. It's another underdog story. Just start, the random name pops up in jams, and now he pops up in the grand finals. DJ Ozzy, taking the team by storm.
Yeah, I actually never expected this.
No, this not at all. I mean, what did you say your goal was? You said you wanted to get top six, was it?
Like, yeah, top seven or eight, six, okay. seven, eight, somewhere around there. I know I could beat a couple of the guys, or I hoped I could.
And now you're about to ride for $7,000.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, I think it's only fair to give you that a little bit of a break. You have just had probably one of the hardest games of your career.
I never want to see that track again.
It's going to be in your nightmares tonight, bro. Holy Absolutely. Smokes. All right, we should probably let these guys take a quick break. You'll be joining us back on the couch in just a little bit. We're going to go ahead and have Zach with us to analyze that grand final. But three riders remain of the 12 we started with as they battle for the lion's share of $20,000. Do not go anywhere. Strap yourselves in, and the World Championship will have a winner after this break. Don't go anywhere.